I guess y'all are lucky I'm not hanging over the railing. I know I am. There's a German poet once named Rainer Maria Rilke, who entered into a correspondence with a young man who wanted to be a poet. After a while, he collected the letters he had written to this guy, not the ones he had received back, of course, and published them under the title Letters to a Young Poet, surprise, surprise. Well, at one point, all my friends were talking about this book, so I read it. And when I got to the point where he told the young poet to go off into the wilderness and just be alone with nature, it really freaked me out, because I've had enough of the wilderness to last me a lifetime. I'm a city boy. So I wrote this. It's called All Alone. Just beyond the reach of my campfire, the great things prowl. All I can see of them is the occasional splinter of light thrown back at me from a spit-shine fur. It seems they have no eyes and will not know me when they find me. Rilke, if you lived in my house, you would want to be married to someone with a constant presence and love of open windows. All those rooms littered with melting clocks and candy wrappers, occupied by a belligerent dust that finally crowded me out into the world. I walked the streets until walking made the city seem cramped and woke a rusty hinged coffin of desire. And I walked through crowds, walked among the angels of metal, girls with hair the color of tomorrow and boys armored in totems and soft leather, burrowed frantically through layers of nightlife as they peeled away hour by hour till only the inspired and the desperate were left. I swam through hair pungent with the sweat of taut strings and drum pads and traded black market insights into the secret identities of waitresses and bookstore clerks. And I kept walking until I stumbled over the universe in the eyes of a woman, the tide roaring in my ears when she spoke, the sun glowing gently beneath her skin, truth rising from her like steam, her fingertips streaking my body with passion, her wisdom leaking into me as we touched, mercy sliding down my throat and home taking me in. We ran from street lamp to shadow in the midnight city, laughing in sheer joy at our adventurous selves, and for the first time, I embraced happiness as a lover. But you told me that I didn't really know what I had, and that without this knowledge I had nothing at all. Let it be an opportunity, you said. Leave this superficial life and go alone to where the great things hide. And after that, it seemed I could feel your words in the sandpaper wind, stitch them together from passing scraps of conversation, see them floating on the surface of her eyes until even her kisses tasted gray. So I forced myself out of bed, filled my pockets with everything I knew, and went on the road again, looking for the blind spot on the map. And all the things I knew wore holes in my pockets, so with every step there was the chance that something would slither down my leg and disappear. And when my pockets were empty, I sat down and built this fire, and I cursed your name, Rilke. I cursed your faraway face, I cursed the memories you've left for me to find, I cursed your kindness, and I cursed the dark. And the great things heard me, and they didn't care. The great things of this empty world are wind and water, sun and blossom, seed and earth. The thing I left behind is love.
Wow.